Was I supposed to have it on this way the whole time? Well, that's a huge disappointment. Hey, you guys, welcome back to my channel. It's your girl, Renee Carlson, Seattle MUA Renee on Instagram. The first thing I want to do is take off this sweatshirt. It is so hot, and I've always wanted to do this. That's better. I thought maybe if I put on my I'm too depressed to wear makeup and sit in front of the camera, I thought that would be a little bit more productive than sitting on the couch. So here we are. So May is actually Mental Health Awareness Month, and basically, as a student, I wanted to kind of just share a little bit more of my story. As you guys know, I live with depression and anxiety, and you know, it has been a journey. It doesn't just stop. There is no magic cure. It's something that's you have to kind of basically fight with or for, and there could be highs and lows, or, you know, there's just all types of different kinds of mental illnesses. And I do not want to get specifically way too much into that, just because it turns into more of a, either I'm trying to diagnose people or sound like I am, and I am not in any way, I am not at all qualified to do anything like that. But I will leave some resources down below. But 2020 and the pandemic was and is hard on everyone. I think we can say that it has impacted our life in some sort of way. Here in Seattle, they're assessing the situation today, and we're supposed to have an update tomorrow, Tuesday, and then if we go back into phase two, DeLorean, and we have to go back to March of 2020 as far as rules and regulations for King County. It's just, don't come here. Go to a state that is opening, and don't come to a state where everything is closing. But since it is Mental Health Awareness, I just wanted to share a little bit more of my story. Other people could perceive it as, you know, she is just being lazy or negative or just having a bad day. What does she have to be upset about? She has all this makeup, she has these clothes and these dogs, and her life is perfect. Well, that's just not how depression works, unfortunately. If you know of someone that actually lives with chronic depression, I'm not talking about seasonal depression or anything like that. I am talking about diagnosed clinical depression. Then the best thing that you can do is ask that person directly or talk to them. It is probably more uncomfortable on the other person's end, because at least with me, I'm always willing to tell people what's going on. If there's a disagreement or an argument, I am just the type of person that wants to talk about it and resolve it. At this point in my life, if you are in my life, I have made the decision to keep you in my life. And those are the people that I care about. Those are the people that I talk to, that I know I have a relationship with. And I know that they, at the end of the day, support me as a person. So basically, this year, I went to the hospital 3 times. I was told by Bellevue Overlake ER department, after getting fully tested for everything under the moon and the stars, you have some random bug. They couldn't figure out what it was. I do have chronic problems with my kidney and immunity. I'm getting the vaccine on Wednesday. So I had some bug. So I was really, really, really sick. I haven't ever been that sick. And of course it has to come during a pandemic, you know? I mean, I didn't have COVID, but yet I was severely ill. And what sucks and still sucks, and I'm not trying to get pity or have anybody feel sorry for me, my shoulders just look bigger. The stress of being sick, being in the hospital, and not having them able to diagnose me, it kind of just left me in this state of mind. If it happened like this before and we can't figure out why, there's no real reassurance for me to just lay down at night and go to sleep thinking that, you know, it won't happen again. So yeah, that's fun. Not like I have been lying to anyone. I mean, I even did a mental health check-in a month ago. So I'll leave that below if you wanna check out my previous videos about depression and anxiety. But yeah, so this year I've had a lot of it, and it's been really hard on me, like just my immune system, my body. It's just kind of affected everything. So I'm doing my best to, you know, get back into the swing of things, and basically, I guess, try to get back into life, even though we are talking about going back to phase 2. That's gonna be a mess. California is fully open. So maybe I'll just move there, because I cannot deal with this city just being shut down for a year and a half. It's been crazy. You guys kind of requested to have me continue talking about mental health, and I thought right now would be the perfect opportunity. However, before we go, yes, I am wearing sweatpants with my very nice sweater. Very nice. It's from Fashion Nova. We are going to be doing a giveaway. Make sure that you subscribe to this channel. I love you guys. If you're not doing well, just know that you're not alone, and there'll be resources below, or reach out to a friend. Because you are worth it, and think about your goals and what you want, and the rest will figure itself out. I need to take my own advice. I love you guys. Let me know in the comments what else you would like to see from me, and I will work on getting it done for you. I love you guys.